It's hard to be a qualitative researcher in a world that loves quantitative metrics, which demonstrate the magnitude or prevalence of a finding. But there's a quote about this from the Coding Manual for Qualitative Researchers by Johnny Saldana that I always come back to when I'm thinking about this tension. Here's what he wrote. The analytic approaches for most qualitative methods do not ask you to count. They ask you to ponder, to scrutinize, to interrogate, to experiment, to feel, to empathize, to sympathize, to speculate, to assess, to organize, to pattern, to categorize, to connect, to integrate, to synthesize, to reflect, to hypothesize, to assert, to conceptualize, to abstract, and if you're really good, to theorize. Counting is easy. Thinking is hard work. Let's discuss prevalence for a moment. Prevalence means frequency. Frequently occurring themes in qualitative data can highlight things we should probably pay attention to. But if prevalence was the only thing that told us if something was important, then artificial intelligence would render us useless as researchers. Paying attention to the prevalence of a theme is most important when you want to know what proportion of people experience a particular phenomenon. For example, if a survey you've created collects qualitative insights from an open text question, you might pay close attention to how many respondents mention the same thing in their comments. But if you start counting simply how many times that theme gets brought up, it's easy to look at the counts for each of your codes and assume that the most prevalent ones are the most important, even if it was just one participant who brought the same thing up repeatedly. You have to think about salience, too, not just prevalence. Salience means that something is very important, regardless of how frequently it emerges. This could be a problem you uncover that's only mentioned by one participant, but you immediately recognize it as something that needs attention. Or it could be the most prevalent theme in an entire study. Salience is a judgment made by a researcher given their understanding of the context surrounding that insight. AI can't make that judgment for you because salience is something that might shift with time or even emerge as a researcher begins to understand what's going on. To summarize, please don't just code themes that emerge in qualitative data and then count how many times each code is used to figure out what might be important. Prevalence is only one indicator of importance. You can't neglect salient findings that also emerge, even if they only come up once.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.